Welcome back to Let's Play DDO Permadeath. And it's time for the big one, the Tomb of the Tormented. So I've done a bit of preparation for this one. I swapped in Sonic Blast, because I believe that can go through the floor and hit the enemies wandering around in the mazes. I swapped in Dancing Sphere since I think that also affects through the floor. And I picked up Command Undead as well, since it's an undead quest. Not sure if that will be helpful or not. But this will be really tough for a caster since. Since there are no shrines in here, if I remember right. So I got 1,000 spell points, and that'll have to get me through the whole thing. I suppose the other question is hard or elite? It's gonna be tough, but it won't really be. It's going to be tough just based on whether I ran out of spell points, really. It's not difficult, really, in any other sense. Maybe I'll give it a go on Elite. I've done it Elite before. I may have to abandon if it looks starts looking tough, though. Okay.
Gnawing and scratching echoes from the grated passages of the feet, where a group of famished rats fight over a corpse.
I get free healing off of the tormented souls, at least. That might be the only good news in here. As you can see, I'm taking things pretty slowly here. Alright. I was under the impression I could reach through the law. Maybe I'm wrong. Right, puzzle one solved. Okay. This looks plausible so far. A lot hinges on whether I have enough spell points. Man, I really should have swapped in shield. That was merely an oversight up till now, but now it looks serious.
Familiar gnawing sounds can be heard to the northeast of this large great room.
Get the hell over here, skeleton. Okay, that's a lot of casters coming in. See if we can lure them in here. Sweet. Gone before they get here anyway. And this is still plausible. I've still got 2/3 of my spell points, roughly. Well, I used up a lot of my healing over there just on a pretty trivial fight. Oh well, it happens. Okay. This room's nearly clear. Oh no, there's another alcove. Damn. Oh, did move forward. Awesome. Alright, I think I'm on track here. Is that rat one of mine? Skeleton. Well, I guess it's one of mine. No, actually, my rats look... I don't know, are they the same? No, they're different. I'm confused. I actually know these mazes pretty well, so... I can solve them without a lot of thought. Free healing from the zombies, providing I didn't let them hit me.
The pressure on the floor switch causes the doors in the maze to change their position.
Alright, my skeleton's doing pretty well actually. He's got them nicely locked down there. That's about as good a positioning as it gets for keeping the zombies in one place. Where am I going here? I guess I'm going up here. Not the dead end, clearly. Wait, having this other rat that also has the green aura on it is kind of annoying. Alright, I can hit it. Alright, that'll keep it going for a while. Actually, pin my skeleton over here. His placement is good. Okay, this guy's in good position over here. Sweet. Yeah, the warg is dead. Get moving.
The pressure on the floor switch causes the doors in the maze to change their position.
And I think I go up around the outside now. And we find out if that rat actually is friendly or is hostile. I'm guessing hostile. I don't mind the zombies hitting me rather than my skeleton a bit here. I have a bit of self-healing, which he doesn't. Oh, goddammit, they distracted me. No. It's just a waste of spell points having to spend another couple of minutes dueling with the zombies here. It isn't costing me a lot of spell points, admittedly. I'm self-healing off of them. And my skeleton's got plenty of life in him yet. Or, unlife, or whatever one would call it.
The pressure on the floor switch causes the doors and the maze to change their position.
This guy gonna be trouble? Yes, he is. Yeah, I've got his aggro. I know. Not that it matters at all if my rat dies here, actually. Very next one will come straight out and replace him. Okay, rat should be on its way. Where is my... Where did my rat go? Oh, there he is. Well, at least it's a clear path now. mask. My skeleton hits nowhere near as hard as I do, but
pressure on the floor switch causes the doors and the maze to change their position.
But his AC must be much better. He takes a lot less damage from them. Damn, actually I'm healing the carcass eater by dropping these food parcels down to him. Hamish Frank got confused for a minute there. Alright, two down.
A second rat enters, joining the first in its meal. Akam stirs, but does not wake.
Well, that nearly went badly. They killed my skeleton. There's a lot of spell points to get him back.
Intricately patterned grated passages fill the lower level. Still more rats can be heard to the southeast.
Get back here, skeleton. Wasting all my healing on this trivial fight. It's a bit better, larger group. Damn it, hit the wrong spell. Expensive one too. Thank you. Well, getting pretty short on resources here. I've got a bit of healing off those guys. Hey, get over here, skeleton. Spell points. I can't afford to spend much more before the end fight now. There's a lot of these tormented souls in this room. Alright, this is the last white in the room, I think. Okay. Now for the maze. Jeez. And the maze will be very tough. I've got to time all of the traps. Could be here a while. Wow, made it free.
The pressure on the floor causes the doors in the maze to change their position. Thank you.
Yeah, I can't find many spell points for defending my rats in here. I guess I don't actually need this rat to live at this point. I was going the wrong way, wasn't I?
Spewing blood, the rat succumbs to his wound.
Well, turns out that doesn't matter. See what I'm doing in here right now. Blades at the exact wrong end, of course. Okay, rat's in position. This is a tough quest to solo, especially on a caster where your resources are limited. I kind of screwed it up, I missed my moment. I'll have to wait another cycle. Help my skeleton out a minute here. Wait, no, I want this to be going the other direction when I follow it, surely. Okay, so I need to catch it when it goes back past. That was dumb. Wasted a whole cycle there, it doesn't really matter. This is the toughest part of the maze here. Come on, rodents, move it. This one is always very tight. Okay, made it. My skeleton's having a tough time over there, but I need to focus on the moving the rat again. Okay.
The pressure on the floor switch causes the doors and the mirrors to change their position.
Timing's less critical for this last bit. Good job over there, skeleton. Now the timing bit. It'll be real annoying if I die here. Oh yes, perfectly timed.
The pressure on the floor switch causes the doors and knees to change their position.
Alright, we can have a fight. I need to get through it with minimum spell points used. Oh no! Oh! Disaster! Damn it! I'm real low on spell points now. No buffs remaining. Yeah, the famous rats are no match at all for the rats in the maze on Elite. Must have been hardly doing any damage at all. Alright, the rat's in the first safe spot. Alright, this is the tricky one. Alright, Okay, path is completely laid out. I didn't cut that too close. Oh man. Damn it.
Spewing blood, the rat succumbs to.
Ah, damn it. I and the skeleton are looking worse for wear now. All right, calm down. Let my impatience get the better of me on that one. Is the critical bit again. Double checking that I've got my hunks of rotten flesh in place. Much better this time, should be totally safe. Alright, a couple of traps to time and I should be free. Hoping I can beat the end boss with 180 spell points. Otherwise this is going to be the most painful way to die imaginable. I really don't want to throw my healing aura on before I get to the end fight now. Okay, that's more like it. Thank you.
the doors in the maze to change their position.
Alright, well, there's no more enemies at least. In the maze, I mean. Right, I've got the timing down on those traps. You get tails and a cheese grater there, right? Oh boy.
The pressure on the floor causes the doors on the knees to change their position.
I want my skeleton to die now. Perfect. Okay. I've got some blur and greater heroism back on, so I should be immune to the fear effects. Got my usual gear on. Not many spell points. Get over here, skeleton. This is more important.
Spewing blood, the rat succumbs to his wounds.
No spell points to do anything but keep him in the firewall.
The guardian of torment has fallen.
Holy hell, 26,000 XP. 5 whites. I guess I can beat 5 more whites, I think. I'm good till I get to the end of my healing aura. One more. Preferably without waking up too many of those zombies over there. The white inflictors and spirits. Wow, another 3,000. Alright, let's get out of here. Alright, well that was brutal. Thanks for watching. See you next time.